In this video, there will be three parts. First of all, we simplify how we use routing. Second of all, we give simple routing examples, and then we provide the code in Python. Now, routing algorithms are normally split into two, such as linked state algorithms, which we've seen with Dijkstra's algorithm, and distance vector algorithms, which we'll see in this video. The routing algorithm tries to find the minimum cost from one location, the source, to the destination. Then we normally use a graph to represent this network. Now we'll simplify this in this video. Now distance vector algorithms are based on the Bellman-Ford equation. So let's have a look at this. Now you can see the router has three neighbours. It's connected to V, W and X. So we can see the costs of 1, 2 and 3 to get from U to these routers. Now these routers have the distance to the goal, which is the router Z. We have X goes 1 and 2, V goes 2, 1 and 2, and W goes 1 and 2. So 3, 3 and 5 are the distances. Now if we add the costs to each neighbour with the distance to the goal from that neighbour, you can see that if we go via X, the cheapest route, the minimum cost is 4, from U to X, X to Y to Z. So that's the Bellman-Ford equation. When we show a network, we have nodes and we have costs of the arc. What are these costs? Well, the main one is hop, but we'll look at the others as well. So here we have a network, and you can see if we go by the top route, we only have 3 hops. So we go from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 7. So it's devices that we go through. Whereas if we go the bottom route, we've got an additional hop. So hop is one of the primary costs on a network. Another one is bandwidth. Here you can see we've got a rather slow connection if we go the top route. So that's quite slow. But the bandwidth is a lot faster, maybe gigabyte, Ethernet gigabyte, and that's faster. So that's a faster way of going using the lower route. Delay, here you can see there's a slight delay on the nodes before they move the data on the top route rather than the bottom route. So that's delay. And reliability, well, here we've got the top route seems great. It's got a high number, 255, and the numbers go from 1 to 255. So 1 is quite low. You can see here we have a problem just after node 5. And load, you can see the top route already has traffic, which is going to make our data and our datagram passing through to that top network suffering from congestion, like a traffic jam, if you like. And the bottom route is nice and clear. So that way, load is a variable when we're looking at the value. Now in our diagram as well, you can see we've got values, but if you think of hop, how come the networks are just routers connected? But this is a simplified diagram. What we probably have is subnets that are connected. So networks that are connected to other networks, like an internet of networks. So when we see these values, these are not between routers, but subnets where we have multiple routers. So for example, here we could have U connection to the V, but actually that's actually two subnets and the routers are connected, but they're connected via other routers, which we don't see in our main diagram. So we can think of these subnets being represented by the router in the main diagram. Okay, let's have a look at some examples of distance vector algorithms. So here we have our network we've used previously, and we've got the path to the goal node or Z. So if we go from W to Z, we have a path and a cost of 5. We have path from Y to Z and a cost of 2. Now as we go through additional costs that we can find out, you can see that now, going from W to Z, we can have a cheaper cost, a shorter path in cost terms, of 3 rather than 5. So that's a better route to take. It has a lower cost. So when we say shortest path, with this, when we're looking at distance, it may be the shortest distance of hops. Although we can't see it on this diagram because it's general, we can look at the costs, and 3 is less than 5. So we add more costs, and then we can see from each node which is the shortest path to our goal. And finally, once we have all of the costs, we can see from which node what is the cheapest path and what is the lowest cost. What happens if something changes? We can update that with the distance vector. So here we've got a problem. So the connection between X and Y has a problem. So when the data has moved, if something is sent to a node and there's no reply for a certain period of time, then we realize there's some type of fault. So now we can update the values on this network and see which are the shortest paths from each node to the goal, taking into account this updated information. So this is an updated version from the previous example, but with X and Y connection being taken out because of a fault. Now we can keep these values in a table. So let's have a look here. We've got a very small network. We've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. So once we get the values from node 1, we can see we can go to nodes 2, 3, and 4, and we can enter the values from 1 to these other nodes, these other nodes to 1, and also calculate paths from 2 to 3, for example. Now, once we've got these values, we can then travel to the extra nodes and get the values between them, and then we can update our table to get the shortest paths. So you can see the updated information in the table showing the shortest path. Okay, let's have a look at code. We've got two examples. So the first example, you can see we've used before, this tree. So what we want to do, we want to add the edges and now find the cost from one to the other nodes. Here is the code for the first example. We start off creating the network. We define that, and we're going to get the cost from the first node, source 1. Now when we run it, we're going to use the Bellman-Ford algorithm. So the Python code is based on that algorithm. Obviously we have to create our graph and add the edges. So here's the code for our first example, and let's run this, and then we see the shortest path, the least costs from each node to source 1. And here's the output of the code. The second example, we're going to use our network. We're going to change the letters to numbers as we have previously. Now our second example, we just define the network, so the new graph. We also are going to look at the shortest path, the least cost to node 1, and the code is identical. It's the same code we use in the first example. So let's run it, see if it works. And here we have our costs, minimum costs, shortest paths from each node to the first node, node 1. And these are the distances, the output from our code, looking from the lowest cost from node 1. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, please give us a like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe.